sunlit world of what he believes to be reality. But there is, unseen by most, an underworld, a place that is just as real, but not as brightly lit. A dark side.
The anthology-style horror TV series Tales from the Dark Side debuted in October 1983 with a pilot episode before being picked up for syndication starting in September 1984. Created and initially developed by horror master George A. Romero, the visionary mind behind the classic Night of the Living Dead, the show ran for a total of 4 seasons, ending in July 1988. Each episode aired originally by Tribune Broadcasting late at night and was an individual short story that often ended with a plot twist. Tales from the Dark Side featured multiple genres, including horror, science fiction, fantasy, comedy, and even included more lighthearted themes on some episodes.
Jolting Tales of Horror.
If not for the film Creepshow, we may have never gotten Tales from the Dark Side. After the success of Creepshow, several inquiries arose about the possibility of a Creepshow television series. Because Warner Brothers owned certain aspects of Creepshow, Laurel Entertainment, which produced the film, opted to take their potential series in a similar, yet separate direction, including changing the name to Tales from the Dark Side. The new name reflected Creepshow's focus, that of a live-action, EC-based comic book of the 1950s, like Tales from the Crypt and Vault of Horror. Though the series would not carry the trappings of a comic as Creepshow did.
No, this is going to be an entirely new experience.
Over the course of 4 seasons, and including the pilot, there were 90 episodes of Tales from the Dark Side. Many of the episodes of the series were written by or adapted from the works of famous authors. Stephen King, famous for Carrie, The Shining, and more, had his stories, Word Processor of the Gods, and Sorry Right Number, adapted into episodes of the series. Works by Clive Barker, famous for Hellraiser, and Robert Bloch, famous for Psycho, amongst many others, were also featured. A number of stories and episode novelizations were published in the book Tales from the Dark Side, Volume 1, in 1988. After wrapping Tales from the Dark Side in 1988, the series was succeeded by Monsters, a similarly styled, syndicated weekly horror anthology show also produced by Laurel Entertainment and Richard Rubenstein, a collaborator of George Romero, who previously worked on Dawn of the Dead and Tales from the Dark Side.
Tales from the Dark Side.
Following the end of the series, Tales from the Dark Side, the movie, premiered in 1990. The movie featured several stories and included big stars such as Deborah Harry, Christian Slater, and Steve Buscemi. Pulling again from Creepshow, Tales from the Dark Side, the movie, was originally meant to be Creepshow 3, but it was retooled and renamed to take advantage of the Tales from the Dark Side popularity. After original syndication, Tales from the Dark Side was picked up by LBS Communications for barter-based syndication. World Vision Enterprises later became the series' distributor, and rights currently are held by World Vision's successor, CBS Television Distribution. In November 2013, it was announced Joe Hill, son of Stephen King, would be developing a reboot of Tales from the Dark Side with CBS Television Studios for the CW. On February 2nd, 2015, the CW announced that Tales from the Dark Side had been given a pilot order and had been added to their upcoming 2015-2016 schedule. Filming for the pilot episode started on March 19th, 2015, and wrapped on April 4th, 2015. However, on May 7th, 2015, the CW passed on the reboot series. After initial interest from the likes of Sci-Fi, MTV, and VH1, there was no network to pick up the series. On May 12, 2016, it was announced that the first three scripts, all penned by Joe Hill, would be published in a hardcover edition by IW Publishing. This book was published in November 2016. As of the making of this video, nothing new has came from Tales from the Dark Side or the reboot. The series is still fondly remembered from fans and still loved to this day. Until new episodes are produced, we can still look back and enjoy the original episodes that were made. Currently, the complete series is available on DVD. Do you remember Tales from the Dark Side? What were some of your most memorable moments? Make sure to leave us a comment and let us know.